Good morning and welcome. I'm going to talk a bit about the new stewardship special interest group we founded a few months ago. Let's get started. A few words about me. I'm Fabio and I'm called Deckethorpe probably everywhere. So if you look for that nickname, you're going to find me. I'm a packager and a proven packager in Fedora and a member of the packaging committee, the Go special interest group, and founder of the stewardship special interest group. And I blog about the stuff I do for Fedora in the on my blog at deckethorpe.com.
I see your logo there now, and I appreciate what Deckethorpe means.
You get it now, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Short history, how did we get here? This whole mess started in September, and I just thought, let me include some mailing list messages because they probably show what's been happening. First clouds on the horizon were in September, when, I'm planning to orphan Java packages listed below, and the list below was like that long. So there was no reply to that message, which was strange, and nobody cared. And then things got worse. 5 weeks after that, Java packages were going to get retired because they were orphaned for 6 weeks. And then we thought, this is probably not good, and somebody should take care of that, because a lot of packages still depend on these packages. And moving them to maintenance in modules only was leaving a lot of people behind, primarily packages who didn't have experience with modules yet. And so I announced the stewardship special interest group, where we take care of orphans that are probably too important to just retire because other things still depend on them. The last coffin in the nail was probably non-responsive maintainer processes for a lot of Java packages who don't work on Fedora anymore. And now there are still over 500 orphan packages. And somebody is going to have take care of them, or they're going to be retired as well. So, yeah, I think you know what's missing here. Yeah. So, oh no, what are we going to do now? So the SIG we founded is now a fast group for coordinating the packaging efforts. We have a Peggio project where we have tickets and do some basic planning. We have a private mailing list where all the Bugzilla email is going. And it's private because sometimes there are CVEs and they might be private and private issues and so on. We have a IRC channel on Freenode. We have biweekly meetings now for almost 3 months. And there are 11 members now, and most of them are maintaining some number of Java packages now. And we have, as of 3 days ago, 222 packages.
So, do you know offhand how many of those 11 are Red Hatters and how many are not Red Hatters?
How many people of those are from Red Hat? I think Miro is from Red Hat. I'm not sure. Some of Cypher Boy, it's Alexander. He works at Red Hat at the doc tag BKI stack. Dinesh works at Red Hat. He also works on the doc tag PKI package. I'm not sure about the other ones.
Okay.
Yeah, but some of those people work at Red Hat. Some don't, and most of them just depend on these packages and don't want them to get retired or want them to be fixed. So, yeah. Okay, this is the number of packages we maintain over time. So it's been steadily growing with a sharp spike at the beginning. And this doesn't include the 500 orphan packages that are still there. So those are the first 200. And then there are still 500 orphan packages left. And we're working on that. So we still don't know what we're going to do about this, because it's difficult with three or four really active members to maintain 700 packages that are mostly out of date by 2 or 3 years and haven't been touched since then. So that's a bit too much work. So we are thinking about what to prioritize. And the first thing we did was to put out some fires, reduced failed to build from source packages in Fedora 30 from 3 to 0. But that's no longer true, because we had adopted additional packages in the meantime. Then we retired checkstyle package because it was outdated by, I think, 20 stable versions. And it had a number of open CVEs filed against it, so we just got rid of it. And where it was needed, we patched out the dependency. So we made sure nothing important broke there. Then we made some adaptations to our packages, because Eclipse was retired on 32-bit architectures, primarily that was managed by switching OSGI providers to OSGI Core instead of the Eclipse-provided OSGI implementation. And we fixed some CVE issues in C3P0. And yeah, so the worst stuff is behind us now. What we've been working on the past few months is to reduce the package set. So primarily by disabling optional dependencies, so we can drop at least some of the packages. For example, in Apache Common VFS, we dropped support for Hadoop and FTP file system support. Both of these weren't used anywhere. And this fixed a filter bit from source issue, because Hadoop is broken in Rawhide. And it let us drop FTP server package as well, which is only used by that package and was failed to build from source since Fedora 28 or something. Yeah, so that wasn't good either. And MENA FTP server has been retired yesterday, so it's good that we got rid of it. Then we removed unused support for Spock and Groovy from TestNG. That means we didn't have to fix Spock, which was also failing to build since Fedora 29. Removed support for Eclipse Equinox from Xbeam package, which means it doesn't fail to build anymore on 32-bit architectures. Removed support for Hibernate from Xtreme, because Hibernate is not installable on Fedora 31 anymore. So that's fixed. And removed support for Spring and Java Persistence API from some packages, because Spring is broken and orphaned, and it will be retired soon anyway, in 1 or 2 weeks, I think. So we no longer depend on Spring. Yeah, and we've been also working on updating some packages. We've made 25 version updates. We also are handling these via pull requests. So someone files a pull request for a version update, someone reviews it, and then we merge it, because we're not that experienced with Java packaging yet, so we like to have a few more eyes on those changes. There are 5 more version updates pending, and after all that, then there are still 108 out of 222 of our packages are still outdated, but it's getting better. Yeah, the number of outdated packages is slightly dropping, but it looks better that way. So at the beginning, we had almost 60% outdated packages. Now it's more like 50%. So yeah, we're working on it. Then I have a few bit more things to show. Average number of missing updates for our packages is 2. So yeah, on average, 2 stable updates are missing from our packages, which means there are a total of 400 stable updates missing from our package set, which doesn't look so good. But at least the number isn't growing anymore. And on average, our packages have been outdated by more than 400 days. So that means it's been more than 400 days on average since a stable release was tagged upstream, and it's not in Fedora yet. So we're also working on that, but you will notice that if nothing happens, this line slopes up just because time passes and nothing happens, and things get worse over time. Yeah.
Entropy.
Yeah, right, that's entropy. And if you add all these outdated sins, days together, you get that our packages are outdated by more than 100,000 days in total, which sounds a bit scary. But still, we're working on it. Yeah, next steps, we'll try to keep our packages building, which isn't always easy because they're outdated. And yeah, we try to fix fail to build from source issues when they occur. We try to adopt packages that we need before they get retired. And we also try to keep our packages up to date. Now we maintain them. So I've been monitoring upstream releases for all these packages. And for those that were up to date, we try keeping them up to date. And we also try keeping the outdated ones up to date slowly. But we're making progress. Then we try to minimize the divergence between modular packages and non-modular packages. So whenever there's a change in the modular branches, we try to merge these back into the Rawhide repos, just because it makes things easier to maintain in the future. And we don't have to duplicate efforts in both modular and non-modular branches. Right, and we're doing some...
Hi.
We are also trying to remove some unnecessary dependencies, especially some Maven plugins for source code linting and test coverage, which are pretty useless for RPM builds. And sometimes regenerating the build requires in packages also lets us remove some dependencies that weren't actually used. Yeah, then what we'll probably be working on either for Fedora 31 or Fedora 32 is to drop support for Gradle. It's really outdated. It currently can't even build itself anymore. So version 4.4.1, which is packaged in Fedora, can't build version 4.4.1, which is a bit of an issue because not even the Bootstrap build works anymore. And it looks like other distros have given up on packaging Gradle as well, because all distros I've looked at, which includes Ubuntu, Debian, OpenSUSE, Fedora, they all have the same version of Gradle as we do. And the only one, the only distro that has an up-to-date Gradle package is Arch, but they don't build it from source. They just package the upstream binary release. So it looks like they've given up too. Yeah. It's a bit complicated because Gradle added dependencies on Kotlin, and it already depends on Groovy and on Scala and a lot of Java packages. So it brings in a whole big, broad dependency tree, and it's just not maintainable as it is. So we'll try to remove it without breaking too many things. There are only 15 packages in Fedora which are built with Gradle, and they can be ported to Maven if it's necessary. It's already been done for some packages because there's been some, I think there were circular dependencies and Bootstrap issues, so packages like TestNG, JUnit 5, and AcuteBND have already been ported to build with Maven instead of Gradle. So if there's really a package we need that's currently built with Gradle, we can work to port it to Maven. And there's also, I think, 5 packages built with Gradle that are already orphaned, which will be retired in 1 or 2 weeks. And 3 packages we maintain ourselves. So these won't be necessary anymore because they built with Gradle and they depend on Gradle itself. So we won't need this anymore. Yeah, but we'll try to keep breakage to a minimum, and we'll work with package maintainers who depend on Gradle to resolve this issue without too many headaches. Yeah, I think. Yeah, now it's time for questions. Yeah, sure.
Hi, camera. I'm Matthew. I'm the Fedora project leader. This is very interesting to me. So I had a bunch of questions, so I thought I'd come up and ask them. I have three things, really. What order do you want them in? The first one is a general question, the second one's a SIG question, and the third one is a Java question.
Okay. In that order.
Okay. The general question is, we often have people with ideas, there should be a SIG for this, there should be this in Fedora, and then that goes nowhere. This was an idea and it went somewhere. What did you do differently that made this actually work?
I'm not really sure if that's specific to this problem or not, but when I made the proposal, there was instantly interest from some people who said, yeah, we really need to do something about this. But I think it also helped that it was some kind of an urgent issue, not something like, yeah, we have an idea, we want to do something like Llama Fedora system or something. But in this case, there was really an urgent issue we wanted to fix.
And things on fire, then people will do something about it.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So if things are, if things are already burning to the ground, people will show up to put out the fire.
I think more specifically, have concrete actions to work on.
Yeah, right. We really had a few concrete things we had to work on to keep things working, and yeah, that worked really well for us.
So the SIG question is, the Java stuff was obviously a fire. This all seems very Java-focused right now.
Yep.
Is the goal for this to be broader to other things, or is it basically once this fire is contained, maybe we're done, or will we look at other things that might not be getting the maintenance they need to across the distro?
Basically, we didn't want to make this specific to Java. We also maintain a few Node.js packages. There was a few of them which were orphaned as well, and we'll take care of these. But the critical thing was the Java stuff crumbling around us. So that was the, you might say, the ignition point. But if things start to break in the future, we might look at these as well. So it's not specific to the Java stack.
So I guess the second part of that one is, do you see this as something that where instead of individual maintainers picking it up, a group picks up this, and you know there was like eventually we'll own the whole distribution joke earlier. Do you see that as a useful thing? Like maybe we want more of the distribution owned in collective rather than individually?
I mean, that's a difficult question because some people are really hoarding packages and they don't like other people to touch their packages. So we probably won't be able to help these people. But for stuff like all those low-level Java packages that we maintain, nobody really wants to touch them, but everybody needs them. That's really the problem we're having with this. So I think here it's a good thing to have. I mean, that was originally the job of the Java special interest group, but I think it has only one or two members now. And for such low-level stuff, nobody is really interested to work on it. But everybody needs it, so somebody needs to work on it. And I think that's easier when you have a group of people instead of having maintainers maintain some low-level dependency they don't really care about.
I So that segues nicely into my Java question, which is, I think the Java world in general has rejected the idea that packaging up Java in RPMs is useful. Basically, when you're doing, you know, deploying a Java application, you deploy it in jars or whatever, guars, and these things that are, you know, lots of bundling, and that is the approach people use. Nobody in production says, I'm going to make an RPM out of this and ship my things that way, except for a few crazy outliers who really love RPM, right? The point of things being in RPM is when we ship those things in Fedora in some way. So the free IPA dog tag thing makes a lot of sense because that's an application that uses Java in Fedora, so we need it in RPMs, even if we don't, you know, even if that's different from the way Java is deployed in a lot of places. So have we looked at the dependency tree of all these things and made sure that everything we're doing is in service of an actual application in Fedora, or do we have a bunch of stuff where it's like, we packaged this jar, so hopefully maybe somebody will use this jar?
That's actually something I've been working on since the beginning, and I have some, we have some scripts in the Pagura projects. I can show them since we have a few minutes. I have a script that checks all our packages, which other packages depend on them. Are they owned by our SIG? Are they an interesting package? Stuff like this. And if it's not dependent on by anything we want to maintain or we can maintain, then we try to drop these packages as well. So we try to not only cut down the dependency from the side, but also from the top.
Okay. So how many applications like Eclipse or Dogtag are there in Fedora that require Java at this point? Is it tens, hundreds, five?
I'd say probably low dozens. It's hard to say because I'm not really that's invested in the whole Java language world, but the things we care about are the Dogtag PKI stuff, because we have members who maintain these packages in Fedora and can't modularize them in Fedora, but they maintain them in modules in RHEL, so it's a bit difficult in this situation. And there are some other packages we want to keep building. For example, Maven is important because just almost every Java package is built with Maven. Right. And we can't remove that because otherwise we'd break 1,000 packages or something like that.
So that's infrastructure stuff. So I guess one of the other questions is, how many of the jar dependencies are actually shared between, like, how much, you know, overlap is there between Dogtag and Eclipse? How many packages are kind of like singleton dependencies? This is only packaged because it's part of this one application.
I see where I'm going with that. I mean, Eclipse is already maintained as a module in Fedora, so they've already dropped support for Rawhide in essence, and it doesn't build in Rawhide anymore because some of their dependencies were already dropped. And I think Matt maintains the Eclipse packages, Matt Booth, and he helped us with some of the things to unbreak dependencies which were broken because Eclipse was dropped on 32-bit arches. But he's primarily interested to maintain Eclipse in his modular branch. So that's not really an issue for us anymore. Dogtag PKI stack has some dependencies in Java, but it's all a bit of a mess because there's a lot of circular dependencies in the stack, and we've tried to break some of these dependency circles by disabling optional support for things, removing sub-packages that weren't used, disabling some modules that just were built because we could build them, but we didn't need them.
Right.
So we really tried to cut things down to the bare minimum that's actually needed to make sure that we actually can support this, because it's not sustainable the way it was.
Awesome. Thank you very much for this. Yeah. I really appreciate it.
Thanks. Okay.
Thanks. So people on the recording, there was a vast audience in the room, but they were just very quiet.
Yeah. Thanks for coming.
Actually, I have a question. You said a lot of these packages have been modernized in RHEL, but not in Fedora.
Right.
Why?
Lack of the Ursa Major and the way that we can't build things in the builder with.
Okay.
On the
That's okay.
And an issue why we can't do this in Fedora is because the Java packages module isn't really usable for other packages. So it's there, but nobody can really use it. So people have to rely on the normal Rawhide repo to build stuff, but nobody cares about the Rawhide packages. So, yeah.